Good morning.
My apologies for being a little late getting started. It's my first time in doctor and I'm a little discombobulated. It is good to see you all though today. I know that it is a wet and muddy and somewhat cool day out, and so I'm so glad that you decided to come to worship, to join us in warmth and in fellowship. And it is just good to see you because I miss you all when I'm away. I know. It's crazy, right? But I missed you all.
We missed you too.
Well, thank you. Hey, wait a minute. thank you to the people who were leading worship in my absence, to Beth Callan, to Gail and Lori over in Limerick, and Doug Felsen on the snowy day. He had to figure out what he was doing in bad weather. So I appreciate you all. You are amazing, and I'm so grateful to have you be able to step in and lead our congregation so faithfully. So thank you for that. The only other announcement that I have is that we have an official board meeting this Tuesday at 7 o'clock. That is going to be here in the flesh. Because we were in Limerick last time, right? Okay. So we're going to be here in the flesh at 7 o'clock. I forgot to put it in your bulletin, so I apologize. But Tuesday, that is November 1st at 7. So if you are on the official board, or you know somebody who's on the official board, please plan to attend or tell them to instead. Any other announcements? I guess the other one would be that today is our food drive. I see a whole boatload of food in the little porch area over there. So thank you for those who have donated. If you haven't brought your food in and you still want to, we are going to be collecting from 12:30 until 2 o'clock today here in the church parking lot. So if you're interested in that, we would be grateful to accept anything that you can offer. All of the donations from here in the flesh will be going to the Gravelburg Food Bank. We will also be accepting donations in the Limerick Church parking lot, and everything there is going to the Assiniboia Food Bank. So we are trying to help to replenish our food banks a little bit after the holidays, after Thanksgiving. Everybody kind of remembers to donate in the lead up to that, but they often end up being there after the holidays. So we're trying to help them out with that. And it's our Halloween for Hunger food drive. So if you feel like anything to cost you when you come to deliver your food, feel free. I was thinking about it and then I probably forgot my costume at home. So I don't think I will. We begin our worship this morning, as we always do, by acknowledging the territory. This is something that we do not because we have to, but because it is good to do. We do it because it is right and good that we think about those who have come before us, repent, and ask forgiveness. So as we gather together this morning, it is with great respect that we acknowledge the history, spirituality, culture, and gifts of the peoples with whom Treaty 4 was signed, and the Lakota Nation and Métis people who call this area home. We acknowledge the land on which we live, move, and work as land that was first and is still loved by those who care for and nurture Turtle Island. We acknowledge and accept our responsibilities as treaty members, and we pray that what we do here creates a space where all may work toward peace, friendship, and respectful relationships. May it be so. Our call to worship is printed in your bulletin, and as always, you read the bolded parts. We come together from many places and from different directions, with many duties and tasks that seek to lay claim on our lives.
This day, in this place, we open our hearts to the earth. We share our burdens and our joys, and we choose again to worship.
Blessed be the God of creation who has called us here.
Where we will not hide our face in the grace of God's generosity and love.
Come, let us worship together. And so we light our Christ candle today, remembering God's love in our lives. we light it as a visual reminder, as a physical reminder to us that the light of Christ goes with us in every moment of every day. When we come together in worship and when we go back into our daily living. And let us pray. Holy God, we come to worship this day, knowing that you love us more than we could ever understand. We come ready to hear your word, to recommit ourselves to you, and to willingly follow wherever the Spirit may lead. Be present in this place, we pray, and guide us so that when this time of worship is over, our service may begin. Amen. Our first hymn this morning is number 371 in Voices United, that's the Burgundy book. Open my eyes that I may see. Then I took your father Abraham from beyond the river and led him through all the land of Canaan and made his offspring many. I gave him Isaac, and to Isaac I gave Jacob and Esau. I gave Esau the hill country of Seir to possess, but Jacob and his children went down to Egypt. Then I sent Moses and Aaron, and I plagued Egypt with what I did in its midst. And afterwards I brought you out. When I brought your ancestors out of Egypt, you came to the sea, and the Egyptians pursued your ancestors with chariots and horsemen to the Red Sea. When they cried out to the Lord, he put darkness between you and the Egyptians and made the sea come upon them and cover them, and your eyes saw what I did to Egypt. Afterwards, you lived in the wilderness for a long time. Then I brought you to the land of the Amorites, who lived on the other side of the Jordan. They fought with you, and I handed them over to you, and you took possession of their land, and I destroyed them before you. Then King Balak, son of Zippor of Moab, set out to fight against Israel. He sent and invited Balaam, son of Beor, to curse you. But I would not listen to Balaam. Therefore he blessed you, so I rescued you out of his hand. When he went over the Jordan and came to Jericho, the citizens of Jericho fought against you. And again, and also the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Girgashites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. And I handed them over to you. I sent a hornet ahead of you, which drove out before you the two kings of the Amorites. It was not by your sword or by your bow. I gave you a land on which you had not labored, and towns that you had not built. And you live in them. You eat the fruit of vineyards and olive groves that you did not plant. Now, therefore, revere the Lord, and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Put away the gods that your ancestors served beyond the river and in Egypt, and serve the Lord. Now, if you are unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. Then the people answered, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord, our God, who brought us and our ancestors up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, and who did these great signs in our sight. He protected us all along the way that we went, and among all the peoples through whom we passed. And the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who lived in the land. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God." But Joshua said to the people, "You cannot serve the Lord, for he is a holy God. He is a jealous God. He will not forgive your transgressions or your sins. If you forsake the Lord and serve foreign gods, then he will turn and do harm to you and consume you after having done you good." And the people said to Joshua, "No, we will serve the Lord." Then Joshua said to the people, "You are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen the Lord to serve him." And they said, "We are witnesses." He said, "Then put away the foreign gods that are among you and incline your hearts to the Lord, the God of Israel." The people said to Joshua, "The Lord, our God, we will serve, and him we will obey." So Joshua made a covenant with the people that day and made statutes and ordinances for them at Shechem. Joshua wrote these words in the book of the law of God, and he took a large stone and set it up there under the oak in the sanctuary of the Lord. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
So that scripture is quite a bit about making choices. So I thought we'd talk a little bit about making choices today. I'm going to give you two options, and you have to choose one. You have to vote for one or the other. None of this, "Oh, I kind of like both of them" kind of stuff. You have to choose one or the other, okay? So the first two options. If I can get my fingers to work, the first two options. Are you a cat person or a dog person? How many cats? Okay, how many dogs? I think the dogs win it on this one. All right. They're both cute. All right. How about a pizza person or a hot dog person? Which do you prefer if you have to make a choice? Pizza? Hot dogs? Okay, the pizza. Pizzas win. All right, let's see. Here's a good one for right about now. Do you prefer summer or winter? Summer. I think that's everybody. Winter? That is a unanimous. Well, it's not quite unanimous because I would choose winter. But that's because I tend to pass out in the summer. So. Yeah, but if you have to make a choice between one of those two. All right, how about something a little different? How about purple or orange? Purples? Oranges? Purples? Oranges. Okay. I thought I saw a couple of you not vote, so I thought I better just double check. One that I don't know if this is if you guys watch either of those. Are you a Star Trek fan or a Star Wars fan? Those ones are like, oh my god, we're fighting against each other, so I thought I'd try it out. Star Trek? Star Wars? We've got a Star Trek and a Star Wars in the same family. God help you. Sometimes it can be hard to make choices. Was it hard or easy to make those ones? Easy? Right, exactly. These are simple and fun, right? They're not something that is going to change the way you live, whether you like a cat person or a dog person. Sometimes it can be really easy to make choices, and sometimes it can be really hard. But we don't have to make our choices alone. We make our choices with God, and we make our choices with our community. And so it's always good to have a community around you, to be able to come and say, you know, and maybe you don't have to ask everybody because you don't necessarily trust everybody to help you make a decision. But to have a couple of people that you can trust fully, that you can go to and say, I have these two or these three or these four different options in front of me. I need to make a decision. I need to make a choice. And I don't know what one to do. Can you help me? And if you don't have those people, or even if you do have those people, you can do the same with God. And it might not be a thunderbolt and lightning that you all of a sudden have the answer. But when you come to God in prayer and making decisions, more often than not, you do eventually get that answer. You do get that feel of which you're supposed to do. And so that is my encouragement to you, to never have to make your choices alone. Never have to feel as if you are alone in this world. When you're making the easy choices between purple and orange, and when you're making those life and death choices that so often come our way. Our next hymn is going to be number 509. Is that what it is? Here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord. One of my favorite hymns. Number 509 in Voices United.
Stars are
They actually have to do it. Joshua challenges them, their decision and their commitment, almost saying in a way that this is harder than you think. You can't commit to God and then change your mind. You have to be all in and live a God-filled life. And then there's the other side of it that I say all that, but the honest truth is I wasn't there listening to Joshua. And maybe when he added those lines that I struggle with, he actually was just unsure of the people's ability to truly follow God, not just in word, but in deed. Maybe when he said, you cannot follow God, he meant it. Let's face it, by this time in his life, having wandered in the wilderness for a very long time, he saw firsthand the trouble that they got into with God, and maybe wondered if they had it in them to choose God fully and to follow God completely. I guess in the end, it doesn't matter what Joshua meant, because the outcome was the same. The Israelite people doubled down in their profession to follow God. The Lord is the one we will serve. They made a choice, and that choice was clear. Once the challenge was accepted and the choice was made, Joshua wrote it all down as a renewed covenant between God and the people. And then he placed a large stone under a mighty oak as a visual reminder of what had happened and the commitment made. The people chose God, and God chose the people. A promise to always be in communion with one another. You know, we're not all that different from our ancestors and early disciples. Just as they had other gods and idols to choose from, we do too. There's a lot in our world for us to believe in, different paths and leaders to follow. Our choices may differ from those long ago, but they still present us with choices to make. We have to decide individually and as a community what is important to us, and if it is God that we will choose to follow. The decision to choose God is not always an easy one. As Joshua suggested, it's an all-in endeavor. Choosing God is not a one-and-done experience. It's a lifelong covenant that connects you and God in ways that are unmeasurable and often unexplainable. It's more than just being baptized or confirmed, although those are all good things. It's more than just showing up to church on Sunday, although I'm glad that you're here. It's so much deeper than that. It's actionable. It's always, and it's every day. Choosing God as the Israelites did with Joshua means that we honor God in the little daily things, how we treat people, especially those who may act or look or speak or see differently than we do. Do we lie and cheat, or do we stand by our principles even when they're unpopular? What kind of organizations do we support? Do their values and care align with our own? Choosing God is living for God in everything we do and everything we say every day. Every week at our offering time, we talk about stewardship, although we don't always call it that, and what that means within the church and beyond our walls. And I think it goes back to Joshua's question, whom do you choose? One of the gifts that we are given when we choose God is the ability, understanding, and compassion to reach out, to help, to make better, and to care for all that God has created and all that God loves. And so as we focus on stewardship, not just in that one moment each week, but throughout the whole week and year, we ask ourselves some similar questions to those who have gone before us. Questions about how we live our lives in all aspects of our lives. So I invite us to let our answers be the same as the Israelites, and to let all creation stand as witness to our proclamation, we choose God. The covenant that Joshua renewed is the same one that we renew with our Creator every day of our lives. So choose for yourself this day whom you will serve. As for me and my house, we serve the Lord. Our next hymn this morning is number 506 in Wise Life and Let It Be. So I invite you to join with me in these words. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God who has created and is creating, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect in creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus crucified and risen, our judge and our hope, in life, in death, in life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. As I said, each week at the offering, we think about what we offer to God. We think of our time, our talents, and our treasure. This week, we also think about the food donations that are coming from our congregation and our community and going to our local food bank to help them out. I invite you to think about what it is that you offer as we sing together our offertory hymn, number 541. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Doxology. Thank you. you first give to us. And so we give them back to you now as a token of the love that we have for you. May they be used to further your work in this church and in the world around us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Let us pray. Radiant God, we are grateful each day for the many gifts and opportunities you present to us. We appreciate the gift of each changing day, the gift of lives well lived, the gift of our loving families and church community. Bless these gifts and bless us as we receive them. Thoughtful and loving God, hear our prayers for your universal church, for this congregation, its mission and ministry, for our volunteers and our leaders and all who serve you. Energizing God, as we are empowered by your abundant love to heed your call and meet your challenges, we are all unique thanks to your grand design, each with different abilities and roles to fill in the life and work of your church and the world around us. Be with us as we discern what it is that you would have us do, individually and as a community of faith. As each person among us seeks to discover how you would have us use our gifts in this time and place, be with us, gracious God, and help us to hear your voice leading us. Divine God, we lay before you our concerns for all those who are ill or in pain, those who grieve, those who feel lonely, desolate, or unloved, those who are oppressed and endangered. We also give thanks for all the celebrations and good news that we experience. The birth of a child, another birthday, a personal goal achieved, and the love of family and friends. Hear our prayers of concern and gratitude this day. God, hear our prayers. As this day we praise your holy name, and in thanksgiving we lift our lives to you, honoring our relationships as we pray together those blessed words taught to us by your Son, Jesus the Christ, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and the glory forever and ever. Our final hymn this morning is number 242 in Voices United, Let All Things Now Live.
Thank you.
friends, go from this day choosing whom you will serve, knowing that you walk always beside the God of the covenant. And as you go, may you go with the blessing and the love of God, who is our creator, our redeemer, and our sustainer. Jesus, who is our elder brother, and the Holy Spirit of life within you this day and evermore.